Part of the heat chapter. Here we will explain the application of heat in our daily life. How this heat help us in our daily life. We might have heard the term sea breeze and land breeze. The sea breeze, where breeze means a cool air, and the air which transfer from sea to land, that is called sea breeze. So the wind blowing from sea towards the land during the daytime. When the breeze, that is a cold wind, blow from the sea towards the land, that is called sea breeze. Generally, this takes place in the coastal area. In coastal area, what happens during daytime? The sun becomes very hot and the land becomes very hot during daytime. During daytime, when the sun scorches their sunlight, the land becomes very hot. And when the land becomes very hot, its air present on the land rises up. The land's air rises up, and when the land's air rises up, the cold air from the sea, the cold air from the sea take the place of the hot air which is vacant by the hot air on the land. Again, I'm telling you, during daytime what happens? When the sun rays comes on the land, the air becomes heated. The air becomes warm, the surrounding becomes warm. And you know, when the air becomes hot, it rises up. And when it rises up, then it goes into the atmosphere, and from the atmosphere, it blows toward the sea. During daytime, what happens? The sea becomes colder as compared to the land. So from the sea, the cold air moves towards the land to take the place which has become vacant by the warm air. So in this way, during daytime, the movement of the air, that is from the land, that is hot air moves towards the sea and cold air moves from the sea towards the land. So here, the wind blowing from the sea towards the land, that is called sea breeze. So this takes place during daytime in the coastal area. And second, there is the land breeze. Here in the land breeze, what happens? The breeze from the land moves towards the sea. That is during night time. Here this takes place during daytime, but land breeze takes place during night. What happens? In the night, when the sun sets and moon comes out, the land becomes cooler and the sea remains warmer. So what happens? This warm air rises up and it moves towards the land. From this side, the sea remains warmer in the evening even, and when this warm air rises up, then it moves towards the land. And from the land, by the evening, the land becomes cooler. And from the land, the air moves towards the land. So here, the land breeze takes place during night, where the cold air or cooler air moves from the land towards the sea. But here in the sea breeze, the air or the breeze moves from the sea towards the land during daytime, and during night the cold air moves from the land towards the sea, and from the sea hot air rises up and it moves towards the land. So this phenomena is known as land breeze, and this phenomena is known as sea breeze. Now question arises, why do we wear dark colored clothes in the winter? Because dark color clothes are good absorber of the heat, and when it absorbs the heat, it keeps our body warm. It keeps our body warm and we feel hot, and we do not feel cold during winter season. So generally we wear dark colored clothes in the winter season. On the other hand, we wear white cotton clothes in the summer season, because white cotton clothes are reflector of the heat. It is a bad conductor of heat. So heat is not absorbed from outside and our body remains cool. So that is why we wear white clothes, cotton clothes in the summer season and dark colored clothes in the winter season. The same type of question is that the woolen clothes keeps our body warm during winter season, because woolen clothes are insulator, that is bad conductor of heat. When we wear the woolen clothes, the heat from our body remains inside, because the heat which comes out from our body, that is trapped by the air present in the woolen clothes. And since woolen clothes are the bad conductor of heat, so it does not allow our body heat to come out. So heat is trapped inside the woolen clothes only in the air. So we feel warm, we remain warm when we wear the woolen clothes. So because woolen clothes are bad conductor of heat, so it traps the heat which comes out from our body in the gaps or in the airs of the woolen clothes, and we remains warm in the winter season. Now there are some formula by which we can change from centigrade to Fahrenheit or Fahrenheit to centigrade. So here there is some formula. Here first formula, that is C by 100 is equal to K minus 273 by 100. This is the first formula, and K becomes, that is Kelvin, K for Kelvin. It is also unit of the temperature. Generally unit of temperature is degree centigrade. It can be also measured in the Fahrenheit, and it can be also measured in Kelvin. So Kelvin and Fahrenheit are the traditional old method of the measurement of the heat. Nowadays centigrade or degree centigrade is used for the measurement of the heat. So unit of heat nowadays, it is degree centigrade. It can be converted into Fahrenheit or it can be converted into the Kelvin. So here the first formula, C by 100 means centigrade by 100 is equal to K minus 273 by 100. K, value of K, that is 273, that is C plus 273, that is value of K, Kelvin. So 1 Kelvin becomes centigrade plus 273. Now if you derive this equation, then it becomes F, C is equal to F minus 32 by 180, means C by 100 is equal to F minus 32 by 180. And another formula, that is if you convert, take out the value of Fahrenheit, then Fahrenheit is equal to F is equal to 9 by 5 into C plus 32. So if you have to find out the value of Fahrenheit, from this equation we can find out the value of Fahrenheit if value of centigrade is given. If value of centigrade is given, then we can find out value of Fahrenheit. If the value of Fahrenheit is given, then we can find out value of C. So here this is second formula, that is Fahrenheit is equal to 9 by 5 into C plus 32. Thank you.